Welcome back to the workshop. We are going to do a cool pre-unboxing of a new kit from Salvinos JR Models. This is presented by modelroundup.com. They sent this over for review. I will link down in the description where you could snag yours on a pre-order, and then when it arrives, you'll be able to get this for yourself. This is the 1971, as it says, Chrysler Plymouth. We know what this is. It's a Roadrunner. Yes, Petty's Roadrunner, the number 43, the solid blue car, 1/25th scale, which means this should be being built on top of Salvinos' own Charger chassis that they designed. And we're going to take a look at all the parts in the box. This is getting built. I'm just doing an early little Friday bonus fun unboxing kickback. The weather's changing in Wisconsin. We're going from 68 degrees today to like 28 tomorrow. So I thought, get in the basement during this big storm and we will do a cool unboxing and let you folks see it, because the mailman just dropped this thing off and I ran downstairs and I was like fumbling the box and I was like, oh man, I can't. This has got to be the next build. This has got to be the next build. So I will be working on this as we see it. You can see it's got reference pictures on the outside. It's got the cool box art. Talks about their other awesome kits. And they're coming out with stuff like every month. All the modern Camaros. They've got so much cool stuff in the pipeline. There's that 71 Charger that I'm pretty sure this model is going to be based on top of, just with a different body. They've got so much awesome stuff. And they've got new contracts they're writing every day. We're going to be seeing a lot of awesome modern race cars from them, with different decal packages and drivers and hopefully other vehicles as well, if all that stuff is true. So let's take a look at the parts. They are molding a lot of stuff in color now, which doesn't matter if you don't like it, just paint over it. But this is a gorgeous Petty blue, which is the color of the car. Petty blue parts trees for our roll cage, window net. Now the window net is separate from the roll cage, which means you can put it in or you can leave it out. Just like in this picture, there's no window net in it because he's not sitting in the car. We've got our body pans here, back of the roll cage, got our wheel backs, so many parts. These are such detailed kits, and this will be the first one I think where I actually do the assembly part on camera. So most of the interior and body parts themselves will be molded in this Petty blue. We can see all the hemi parts here, all of our intake parts, valve covers, headers, belt and pulley system, water pumps, fans, air cleaner, crossover. Yeah, and then we got through the headers, the mounts, the flanges for the headers on there. We can take a look at that. Let me set up for the next pieces. Now, of course, they have to reuse a lot of the parts and stuff, so you will end up with extra parts. You will end up with some stuff on the side, and that's just bonus stuff you could use for a shop diorama. You got an extra window net. We got valve covers because they want us to use this chassis here that's different from the stuff that was run in the Mopars. We got our nice dashboard with flat faces on the gauges. Got some wheel backs. Got those nice wheels there. And the chassis, we're seeing a little bit of flashes. They use the molds a lot, but it's no big deal. It pops off super easy. We don't have any problems at all. You can see the fine detail on there. Like I said, we're going to be building this on camera. I'll use the same unboxing for that video, but then we'll be building it on camera. Now let's get to the Roadrunner parts. Oh, look at that nose. The rear bumper. We're going to have a couple bumpers in there because we're not just going to do one variation. Check out the carburetor on there. Jim's been working so hard. Jim at Salvinos JR, Jim for Jim Rogers. Great guy. I've talked to him on the phone so many times. So we just look at the detail on there. Got the little headlight circles in the grill. Got the rear bumper with all. Count the rivets now. Go around and count them. Jim designs all this stuff, gets it off to molding. The guy, I don't know when he finds time to actually live a life. Here we've got the hood. Look at the hood pins molded in. That's the type of level of modern molding you expect. I mean, they're 3D, and they're not just a lump. There's a hood pin in there. You could run like a, you know, it's just awesome. Different bracing for the interior, insides of the windows, for the aerodynamics. excellent tree for the Roadrunner. Got the lower grill there. That will take a nice little black wash in there. It's even got texture, super fine texture. And now, molded in blue, the Petty Blue body. Oh, yummy. That Roadrunner, and Jim's sent this back and reworked it. Even got the Plymouth emblem on the hood. He's worked so hard to get this out. Little round of applause. Round of applause for getting this out into modelers' hands. I know you folks will be excited to build this. The trunk, even the trunk on the body mold's got those 3D pins. Can't call them hood pins around the trunk. The correct bracing. And he listens to advice from other people that know far about this from any of us. He listens. All right, let me grab the other parts because they're molding stuff in different colors with the cars now to make building easier for the layman. You can always paint, but they like to make stuff a little easier for the layman. So let me grab some of the other parts and we'll come back with those. Okay, we've got trees of silver parts now. Very nice looking metallic. Of course, these are going to have extra parts in there and stuff used over. We got our rear suspension blocks. They look even cooler in the silver and they're easier to show you. We've got steering links, chassis supports or drive shaft braces, front shocks, steering. Look how nice and thin those still are after all those molds. Front suspension, upper roll cage parts for under the hood. What else we got over here? We got some more header pipes. We've got ductwork and radiator for under the hood. We got the transmission pan, oil coolers, exhaust. This is all stuff you'd paint silver anyways. Exquisite looking. It's an extra set of headers on there. Oil coolers. On this one, we got the nice V8 transmission. Got our differential halves. Got our cover with even a little drain molded in. Got our gearbox, fuel tank. The seat in the silver, you can really see those belts molded in. Fire extinguisher, suspension, shock absorbers. These are where your coolers mount. Steering wheel, pedals obviously, belt and pulley system. Nice set of parts there. And in one of the parts bags will be a steel axle. So be very careful when you unbox yours for building. This steel axle with the knurls on each end will be in one of the blue parts bags. It'll be sitting in there. They toss it into each one. So let me grab the final stuff in the box and I'll be back in a second. Last up will be the final parts in the box. We got our windshield with the bracing. You can color that those braces and the windshield frame from the back. They are nice and prominent. And from my experience, the glass fits well on the Salvinos designed kits. Some of the older monogram ones, you can see it looks like it's distorted because it's so far away and it's a bent piece of glass. But right through the window, it's crystal clear. Doesn't distort in the interior. Super sharp, very, very nice. They've got tires in this one with a little bit of tread and the nice round sidewalls. Solid rubber, so do not glue your wheels together. They will compression fit. They will fit super tight into those tires and look awesome. A light sanding around there, and those are going to look every bit of a scrubbed gummy tire around the car. You get a set of four of those, obviously. And they even smell good. I like doing that with the rubbery tires. They even smell good. And then, if that's not enough, official power slide decals in every Salvinos kit. It's got all your lettering. It's got the nice dash gauges. That's why they got the smooth dash. Goodyear tire logos. Those go on so nice and look so great on those cars. Hood pins if you want to shave down the ones on the kit. Sponsor decals. Petty's car didn't have it. It wasn't all completely covered in sponsor decals like they used to do. Got the Southern High Point, the Plymouth logos, the 43s for the grill. Nice set of decals on there. You can see the white reflecting for the Southern High Point, North Carolina. All the white on there, the tire decals in the center. Excellent decal sheets. I never have a problem with it. Take a look at the Roadrunner manual. We got the design right there. Now go online and decide which one you want to build. There are some variations. So decide if you want, you know, the all blue car. You can see on this one, the grill and the bumpers all blue all the way around. The color guide shows you what the option for the metallic bumper and grill. Full paint guide, decal call out and colors. And then they always are working on the instruction manual, improving little bit by little bit as they go, making sure that you know what's supposed to be going where, and clarifying things that buyers say, well, you know, this didn't seem real clear to me. What's going on here? You know, I really don't see stuff. And then they'll give you options for the parts. Part 108.1 for 71, 108.2 for 72, all that kind of stuff. Which bumpers to put on, the grills, all that fun stuff. These are quite easy to assemble. Even an adult first-time modeler could get one of these together without issue. So I'm going to have a slideshow of all those parts trees at the end of this video with some music to jam out to. We want to thank ModelRoundup.com and Salvinos JR Models for sending this over. Once I get done with this, I'm going to actually start building this car, and that will be a build video coming up. For the rest of you, just enjoy this unboxing, and when you see the longer video coming up, you're going to get to see me put this bad boy together. Thank you. a couple hours of building leads us to this point to where I can start getting paint on everything. I do have to say they still go together beautifully, and we will get to this body last because holy cow. I like to cut parts separately and then build up sub-assemblies. We've seen me do NASCAR vehicles before, especially a lot of petty vehicles since he's got to be one of my favorite drivers. So I do try to simplify things. I don't build for show builds. I don't build for the world's most perfect accuracy. I want to get a cool looking stock car model together, get the body on it, decorate the body, and then it sits on the shelf. I don't ever have to, like, you know, show it to people and prove that it's a perfect scale accurate build. But there are numerous people out there that love to do that, and that is awesome, and those cars that those people build are absolutely gorgeous. So with that explained, we can see that I've got the steering wheel all together. That's two different colors, so I will get that all painted up. Something I like to do is leave as much on the parts trees as I can, paint it, then snip it off. Usually I don't have to touch up the paint, but sometimes if you do, you just use some of the paint from the can, spray it in a cup, and just dab a little brush on it. So we got our belt and pulley system, we got our breathers across here, and we've got our alternator that I'll have to get painted, and our radiator line. So those are all in the blue tree, and our air cleaner. We can spray those and then with primer and then hand paint them if we desire. Same as like our fire extinguisher and our rear shocks. The front shocks I assembled up in there already since they can't be seen very well. Got our shifter. I want to paint that something different than blue. Got our wheel backs. Now I'm going to be making those blue like it is on the box art, but I'll be doing some work to them before that, and then we will press them into the tires. These are the inside backs of the windows, and I'm guessing that was in, these are installed for aerodynamic reasons or air channeling reasons through the body, with the, you know, with there being no windows in the car except front and back. So these will get painted a metallic tone. The drive shaft will get painted safety white. These parts here, we've got like our steering shaft, we've got coolers, we've got master cylinder, we've got a little fan back here, we've got part of the shroud for the radiator, we've got an electronics box. All that stuff can stay this nice silver. This looks like it's been painted with tester silver, so I don't think I need to do much. Maybe I'll do some black washing to bring out a little bit of detail, but I won't be doing much with it at all. On this part here, we've got our nice wheels. They are, of course, already the nice blue, but I will be painting them with a primer and then overcoating them with another blue just to give them depth and change. They're not quite, every picture I've seen, the wheels, you know, obviously they're going to look darker because they're underneath the fenders and stuff, but they seem to be a little bit of a darker blue than the body itself, so that's what I'll be replicating with mine. The instructions don't mention these nice outlets for the exhaust. They don't mention them whatsoever that I can see. If they are mentioned, Jim is screaming at the camera right now, but I don't see them mentioned. I see the crossover pipe exhaust, the stock exhaust that we're normally seeing. That's what I see in there. But this is on the special Roadrunner tree, along with like the 72 pan and stuff like that. So I'm not sure what the dealio. Maybe you could use either or, maybe it's up to you if you want to run one out each side. I'm not really sure, but I'll follow the manual on that and do it the way it says, and that's how I'm going to do it. But these nice ones, I did glue them together. They need their tips glued on, so I think these would go out opposite directions on the car. I mean, they certainly look like they would. So that's up to you whether you want to use those. You should know, if you're a NASCAR expert, you'd know exactly when those were used on what vehicle and on what day and what the sun was like that day as well. We've got the chair all set up. Very nice racing chair on these. The Hemi is all built. Now, I apologize, in that assembly session, we didn't get to see any of the engine assembly except for some small stuff at the end. I realized the lens cap was on the camera the entire time. I kept telling it to record, record. It was recording, but it recorded all black. So the engine is a beautiful assembly. Nice 426 Hemi. You can see the part colors are mixed and matched on this one, but it builds into a gorgeous engine, including distributor. Look at the detail on that carburetor. Just lovely intake, valve covers. So I will be spraying this the blue, then hand painting the transmission and the valve covers, the carburetor, the distributor. I really enjoy that. Again, I've always talked about that, so I'll be doing that. But what a lovely looking engine. Bolting onto the engine, now we did get to see these, were the headers. I thought they might go together a little difficult, but they did not. Just like the other ones, they go together lovely. I'll be spraying these, and then I will be hand painting the flange that goes on the cylinder head. Those assemble nicely, easily. My recommendation, like you saw, glue the headers together, hold them together with a little clamp or your fingers, and then press and fit that flange on there, and you'll be fine. The radiator is literally just held together with friction, and it's already silver, so I'll leave it alone. The differential goes together, and you can get things lined up. If you build it on the chassis like I did, then I will paint it separately, and we'll attach it. Then I slide the steel axle all the way through. It's easier if you use your bench to center that axle back and forth in there. If you try to just press it in by hand, you may snap the assembly apart. But we've got our springs, we've got our brace, we've got our little cooler mounted on, and then that will bolt on. We've got our shock mounts on there, and all that will go on to the chassis when we are all done. You can see that will lock in nicely. Not a problem. The engine as well, in case you're wondering, well, we got the engine in there. With the headers on, I probably wouldn't. But with the entire thing assembled, the engine will drop in, go right into its hole, and it goes underneath the brace. No problems. It's all in there. Looks nice. And then I will have to very, very carefully, and it's a tight fit, insert my headers from underneath. Right underneath. The chassis itself goes together easily. We got new roll cage parts for that Roadrunner body. We got the fuel tank. If you ever open the trunk, they've got the detail features for you in there. We've got our metalwork in the back of the body. Got our little mirror on there. Got the dashboard together. And got all the roll cage parts together. Now, I do tend to use super glue so I can move much faster. I use model glue, then I dribble a little super glue on it. But you can see all the braces and all that. It looks perfect in there. And I can still get in here and put my dash decals on, paint the top of the dash black, won't have an issue. And then the front suspension, all set up. Though I did make a boo-boo on mine that I can't reverse now without cutting parts, the shock shouldn't be on the outside. They should be on these little pins on the inside. I usually get it right on every single build, but this one, since it's the first one I did on camera, of course I had to accidentally slide those in. And by the time I had the steering together and the lower braces on, I realized, oh man, but that's okay. Got our radiator together in the front, a radiator shroud on the front end. And then all those other parts, the radiator will slide in behind there. And then we'll get our large cowl piece over the top towards the end. So that's it for the chassis. The body also requires a good amount of assembly. You can see the hood fits perfectly. Nothing wrong with that, so we'll take that out. The nose, you watched on camera, not a drop of filler, nothing. That thing just fits. Jim, amazing design. The spoiler fits on the back perfectly. It's got a little inset. No more guessing where to put things on the trunk. It has a little inset as we saw. The rear bumper, the pan, the back roll pan. I mean, look at the fit on that. No filler, nothing but a little model glue. Excellent fit, the little spoiler on the bottom. The nose, I love how we had everything key in. That nose has a large piece to key itself in. Just lovely, excellent work. And I did test fit these two together, and I can do it on camera, I guess. It is a squeeze, you got to spread the body. But you'll see. Well, I'm not going to get those corners in right now. I'm not going to squeeze those corners in because it's going to hold it in super tight. But you can see it, and then all we have to do at the end is just snap those corners in. And we'll be good to go. So you see the chassis fits on there real nice. I'm going to get stuff over to paint. Get all this little stuff painted so we can start decorating things. And I'll see you over there.
Thank you.
If you build right out of the box and do a nice simple build, you can get these things done pretty quick. I'm getting ready to seal everything up on mine, so I figured we'd go over it. I am done with the body aside from the decals. I'm gonna leave it this blue. I'm gonna put the decals on it, and then I'm going to brush on a coat of future floor polish like you've seen me do before, and we're gonna see how nice that blue is gonna look. I'm guessing it's gonna look pretty darn slick and very, very smooth. We've got the hood pins done. We've got the trim done, we've got the glass in with the Mod Podge like I showed. We got the gas cap ready to go. I did the little headlight covers with a silver pin, and then I've got the grills and stuff done with the Tamiya gray wash instead of black. I thought black would be too dark for the blue, and I was right. So I'm glad I didn't use that. The dark gray wash looks just fine on there. And then you saw me hand paint the nose and everything like that. So very, very, very simple work. Why did I use silver Sharpie on the glass or on the windshield trim and Molotow on the hood pins? Well, because the hood pins are, you know, they're molded so beautifully, and that Molotow is more of a paint pen, so the tip gets a lot more wet. And I can tap it on there and it will flow down into those hood pins and look real nice. Then when I do the windshield trim, the Sharpie markers don't flow like that. They only go where exactly you place it. So it's much easier with my hand to get that on there. Plus, the hood pins to me always look like chrome. They're usually chromed, some sort of chromed metal. And windshield trim is usually, you know, a shiny metal, but because of the way they press it in and run their fingers and all that, it always looks like it's almost burnished or brushed. It never looks chrome to me, even on ones where it's supposed to be chrome, in just what I see. So that's why I did it my way. The back glass has got all the metal work on there. We've got our little pieces of trim in here, these little aerodynamic pieces in the back of the window. I did those in a metallic tone, draws a little bit of attention to them. And pretty much our body is done with that. All we have to do is place all of these delightful power slide decals on that and on the tires. So we've got the chassis here. The air cleaner, the manual says white, so that's the color I did it in. And that's sitting on top of the carburetor. We can remove that. You can look down in there and see that nice big honk and hemi that I did in a darker shade of blue compared to the rest of the car, just so it stands out. We've got that nice cowl. That's the silver that it comes in out of the box. Our breathers across there. We've got our valve covers painted black. It's more of an off black that I used on this one. Top of the dash. Got those nice wheels and tire set on the side in that darker blue as well. Did them in the same darker blue as the engine. The rear tires will turn because they're on that metal axle. We've got our interior done. I applied the decals onto the dashboard, got them on there, and we are all set with the interior on there. And then when we turn it over, we can see how the stock exhaust and everything lines up. The headers I applied from underneath, and on this one, they were quite easy to get in there. Sometimes they're very, very tight, but this one went in nicely. And then I just did the minor detailing underneath, not a whole lot. My stock cars, it's more for me the body and all the cool decals on there. All I have to do at this point is snap the two together, which we saw should go quite easy, and then apply my decals, apply the tires, the tire decals. When I talk about decals, I've shown me applying them so many times, but I'll just go over it quick instead of showing how I apply them. I use a X-Acto knife that I use just for decals. Very sharp blade on it. The other X-Acto knives I use for cutting on plastic and stuff like that. That helps me cut everything out perfectly. I use old ashtrays or dishes because they're made out of glass, so they retain heat for a long time. I don't have to have any like little heating pad. A drop or two of super cheap dishwashing liquid from the dollar store. Some squeezy tweezers to hold the decal. Some pointed tweezers to let me move it around very easily. Wet Q-tips. Dip it in, rub it on, and then on a body like this, it's so round and smooth, I won't need any decal solvent. If it's going to have complex curves and all these wibbly wobblies all over it, I'll use a little decal solvent and brush it on the same as I do with the soapy water. And then I have just a nice little cutting board. You know, I get these for like a buck at this thrift store near me that I can cut my decals apart on and arrange them. I like to cut them out per side of the vehicle, do one entire side, then turn it, do the top of the car, then turn it, do the other side, turn it one more time, do the back of the car, and then I am all done. So I'm gonna work on that. This little bit of decals probably got, it's less than an hour, I guarantee it. But we'll have all those done, then I'll brush on a coat of future floor polish over the decals, over the body and everything, and let that dry, and I'll have the final. So what do you think, folks? Salvinos JR Models 125th scale 1971 Plymouth Roadrunner, captained by the King, Richard Petty, is all done. This is the first edition of the 71 Roadrunner kit. I'm sure that there will be other Roadrunner kits coming out. This is a limited edition of 2,500 kits in the Petty livery with this box art and all that stuff. So if you want this one, you're going to have to snag it now. I will link in the description. The folks at Model Roundup will be carrying this kit as soon as it is made available to the general public. I got this copy here. This is the production copy, so there'll be no changes from what you saw in my video than what you would get when you order the kit. It goes together beautifully, and I have to say, once the plastic is clear coated, that seems to be a spot on for the box art for that light blue, that Petty blue. Otherwise, if you wanted to spray paint it, Tamiya light blue, Tamiya French blue are both beautiful colors to replicate that Petty blue. They both work quite well and they look nice. And of course, there's other paints out there by other manufacturers and dealers that will match the paint for you. The kit assembles so nicely. The body drops in. Of course, that chassis, we've used that before with the Chargers and stuff like that, and that Hemi. So we know that that goes together well. That is Salvino JR Models' own design. Jim put that together. He did the body on this Roadrunner. He worked so hard. And look at the fit and the finish on this. I made a point to not use any paint on the body except brush painting inside that grill. That had to be done, but I didn't even paint the spoiler on this thing. I did the hood pins and then the decals with a little bit of the trim work, but we didn't spray any paint on the body or anything, and brushed on that clear coat. It looks phenomenal. And the plastic is thick enough that it doesn't look translucent. It doesn't look like a toy at all. Then we painted the chassis, the engine, the rims, did our hand painting. The decals went on exactly as expected. Even the tire decals, they wrap around everything. Those power slide decals are super thin. The carrier is very thin. They lay down nicely with that warm water and just a little bit of soap. No solvent was needed at all. And they just went down even over the fenders and around the fenders. It just conformed and laid down. I enjoyed the entire kit from beginning to end. So thanks for watching the unboxing last week at the end. That little bonus, I was so excited when it came in the mail. And then we got the full build up this Wednesday. I have other kits on the way. We've got all kinds of stuff coming from Salvinos JR Models. They've got stuff that you might not even have heard of yet. And we've got more kits coming from Model Roundup as well. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. Build your models your way for you, for your enjoyment, because you're the only one that matters when you're enjoying your hobby. And we'll see all of you at the next review.